I think you've earned something for bringing the artifact to us.
Money?
In addition to credits, why don't we set you up with a backpack with some boost capability? You'll need it out in the field anyway. Just mind your head.
Constellation pack, lodge key, and 8,000 credits. Talk to Sarah. To Noel about quarters.
The money, I've got lifetimes worth of books and videos to occupy me. So it's good to have you home.
Don't worry about you.
Your father dropped by. He left a note for you. Here.
He's still here. Dad, why didn't you give me the note yourself? Alright, so there's the lodge key. Constellation guide. Can't actually read that. Note from Dad. Dear Cora, if you could stop by home, there's something I wanted to talk to you about. Nothing urgent, but I would sure like to see you. Dad, why talk to me now? You're right there. Sir Livingston's pistol. There's my wooden duck. Where's the consolation pack? All right, so it's on. Watch my head. Oh, sweet.
You mind putting your signature on some documents? The money related.
I can get up there. Where it's locked. Dad, what do you want?
You've been given a precious opportunity.
Get some things you like.
Seize it and never look back.
Do you need anything?
You know, it's supposed to be us taking care of you, right? I'd like to say we'll pay you back the money you sent home.
No.
Well, I appreciate it. We appreciate it. More than you know.
That's not what you want to talk about.
Stay as long as you like.
Here? Excuse me.
Yes.
I'm going up there. Trying to, anyway. Yeah! I have access. This locked door could not hold me. Report on Constellation. From SSNN, the Settled Systems News Network. The following is an excerpt from a 2283 SSNN news report about Constellation's near collapse. And although Constellation's relevance has been a subject of much debate among the New Atlantis intelligentsia, the disappearance of founder Sebastian Banks was a blow most felt the organization couldn't survive. In fact, Constellation's disbanding seemed imminent until member Chloe Bayo changed her vote in the 11th hour, thus ensuring the group's continued operation, at least for the time being, as well as her unexpected appointment to the position of chair. Got 169 credits there. Look, there's more cred things. 164, 166, 172. Nice.
Have you talked to Vladimir recently, face to face?
Vladimir. It's an hourglass.
Yes, it's Bill. What? Oh, I just don't know how he does it. Up there all alone. So.
Some people love that kind of space. Pun intended.
Pun intended. Cool. Well, then again, she did give me the key. So I didn't actually have to jump up here. That was us testing. Its efficiency. Aja Mamasa's diary. Huh. Seems like just yesterday I was pulled into this exciting new organization, Constellation. We would push the boundaries of human knowledge and experience by exploring farther into space than anyone had before. For all into the Starfield. Oh, cool. It's the first time I heard of Starfield uttered in the game. Or written, whatever. God, I was so young. We all were, but I was the youngest of us all. Now here we are on the brink of disaster. The colony war may be over, but the settled system seems to be waiting for the next one. Exploration is now at best quaint, at worst irrelevant. Fortunately, and it was no small feat, I've managed to put together a list of potential new members. They are Irvin Madani, young biologist and physician from the Free Star Collective. Madani. What do I know that? From Punisher. There's a Madani there. She's in Homeland Security. Barrett, promising young physicist from the UC, a colorful character to say the least. Alice Campbell, woman of action and pilot, claims to have flown every type of ship at least once. Russell Luther, astronomer and former Free Star Collective military, argumentative by effective. What does that mean? Visola Chen, philosopher, historian, specializes in humanity's early days of space exploration. Jintao Min, dedicated to finding truth among the stars. Neon Hitman rumors are troubling. With any luck, this new blood will be just what Constellation needs to keep going. Maybe. From the personal diary of Aja Mamasa, former Constellation chair. Ooh. The mask. Somebody stop me. Desktop geodes. I can display this stuff in my ship, maybe. Like a sundial? All these cool things. Levitating desk planet. Spy glasses. Okay. What's that? Report. The Clark Lewis. I breached the hull. Lewis and Clark. I breached the hull at approximately 1348 Sol time. As expected, all internal systems were offline. Emergency power had ceased to function years earlier, so I was navigating the ship in zero-G. Again, I expected that. Almost immediately, I started seeing the bodies. They were everywhere. The crew, the settlers, all of them, drifting throughout the ship. What surprised me were the obvious variations in the causes of death. Those not in suits were frozen and fairly well preserved, and I imagine some of them actually asphyxiated. Others were emaciated, as if they had starved prior to death and freezing. Others had substantial wounding, gunshot, stab wounds. I even found an arm floating among the debris, but not the owner of said arm. It was when I got to the engine room that things finally started to make sense. Due to my approach, I hadn't noticed it from the outside, but half the compartment was actually gone, completely destroyed. The helium-3 tanks had ruptured, somehow. Sabotage? That's a comma there, right? So why is somehow capitalized? Faulty equipment wasn't clear, but the reactor was gone, blown into space. No helium-3 meant no jumping. No reactor meant no engines, no thrusters. That meant the Clark Lewis was dead in space forever. Maybe they are periods. A few personal logs I discovered only confirmed what I then assumed. Life on the Clark Lewis devolved over the course of the next few years. Some people starved to death, others resorted to violence and even murder. There was even some compelling, though unsubstantiated, evidence indicating cannibalism. For the settled systems at large, the disappearance of the Clark Lewis is a topic of urban legend, like Bigfoot or the Roanoke Colony. Part of the myth held that the ship had made it to some Eden-like planet where the settlers had established a kind of utopia. It's a hell of a thing, knowing something an entire galaxy does not. Holding on to a truth so terrible, you're not even sure it should see the light of day. Chloe Bao's extensive 2282 report on the destruction of the Clark Lewis colony ship, which was reported lost in the year 2257 was a subject of much contention within Constellation. At a time when space exploration was already on a decline, Sebastian Banks feared that the horrifying story of the Clark Lewis and its crew would prevent people from venturing out into the dangerous unknowns of space.
My wife and I have something of an understanding. I'm told that when I'm not here, I'm distracted by what I might be missing and wind up crabby, or my personal favorite, irascible. It has been determined that for the long-term health of our relationship, then I am better off here, rather than simply making things worse at home.
Wow. All right. Whatever works for the two of you, I guess.
I thought I was going to start talking about open relationships. I got an origami sculpture. Scroll holder. Did I look at this? Yeah. I might have, I'm not sure. Chapter 1, Great Expectations. My father's family name being Pirip, and my Christian name Philip, my infant tongue could make of both names nothing longer or more explicit than Pip. So, I call myself Pip and came to be called Pip. That's like word for word. I didn't realize Pip from South Park spoke the opening line, I guess it is, of Great Expectations. They asked him why he's called Pip. Charles Dickens's 13th novel is the coming-of-age tale of an orphan boy named Pip as he navigates the agendas of those around him, like the eccentric Miss Havisham. Yes, Collector of Tears. Nicholas Nickleby. Oh, we looked at that one. Oh, you're making spooky alien soundtrack thing noises now. How big is this place? Dracula! What? Dracula! Chapter 1, Jonathan Harker's Journal, Captain Shorthand. 3rd May, Bistritz? Left Munich at 8:35 p.m. on 1st May, arriving at Vienna early next morning. Should have arrived at 6:46, but the train was an hour late. Budapest seems a wonderful place from the glimpse which I got of it from the train and the little I could walk through the streets. I feared to go very far from the station, as we had arrived late and would start as near the correct time as possible. The impression I had was that we were leaving the west and entering the east, the most western of splendid bridges over the Danube, which is here of noble width and depth, took us among the traditions of Turkish rule. So begins Bram Stoker's 1897 masterpiece, Dracula, a book that would define horror for generations to come. The Origin of Species. Chapter 1, Variation Under Domestication. I might have read this before, guys. I'm sorry if I did. When we look to the individuals of the same variety or subvariety of our older cultivated plants and animals, one of the first points which strikes us is that they generally differ much more from each other than do the individuals of any one species or variety of a state of nature. When we reflect on the vast diversity of the plants and animals which have been cultivated and which have varied during all ages under the most different climates and treatment, I think we are driven to conclude that this greater variability is simply due to our domestic productions having been raised under conditions of life not so uniform as, and somewhat different from, those to which the parent species have been exposed under nature. Darwin's theory on the origin of species on Earth continues through 14 full chapters, ranging from biology to geography and everything in between. That I looked at, I know, and Nicholas. I took an exotic wood decoration. Cooking station. What's that little outburst about? Alright, so there's more rooms down there. There's this one to actually fully look in this one. Yeah, apparently. Funky sphere sculpture. Yeah, I know. My oxygen. Sebastian Banks' speech. The following is an excerpt of Constellation founder Sebastian Banks' stirring 2276 speech to United Colonies leadership about the importance of continued space exploration. That is why, my esteemed peers, I beseech you, do not forgo the dreams of humanity only to plunge civilization into an endless nightmare. The settled system stands once more on the brink of war, and for what? A dispute over space? The cosmos is infinite, and yet, like our earthbound ancestors, we have become selfishly obsessed over what we consider ours. At our core, are we a race of conquerors? Of warriors? No, my friends. If nothing else, humans are explorers. Let us continue exploring. Now is the time to venture beyond the imagined borders of the settled systems and fulfill the dreams of humanity. For if we continue down this path, funding only war and not exploration, I fear there will be no one left to remember why we fought in the first place. Got a point there. I can sleep. But it's owned. Someone else owns it. How dare you own the thing? Oh, there's more up there. Alright, let's look in these back rooms here then. Oh, like a bathroom or something. I cannot use the toilet. What a ripoff. Oh, cool. Someone's bedroom and lab? Notepads. Oh, nice. That's not what I want to do. Fishbowl. Does that board game? I think I have one of those trilobite game piece. I have one of those trilobite things. Game piece Snow Lord. Dumbbells. A toy space. Cool. Oh, digipack. Digipack, digipack. It's mine. General storage area or something. Oops. So Livingston's second journal. I heard tell from some of the old timers that although the Earth suffered its sad fate, that her faithful companion Luna fared much better. Apparently you can still find the remnants of one of the old Apollo missions, something of a secret rite of passage for chairs of consolation if Banks was to be believed. During one of those rare interludes of calm while doing other research on Earth, I figured I could spare the time. I was, as they say, in the neighborhood. I took some serious scanning and a couple false leads, but I found it. To walk in the same place as those earliest of interstellar explorers, unbelievable what they achieved with such primitive technology, I found the whole experience moving, inspiring. I will advise my successor to do the same. We'll make a proper tradition of it yet. This is an excerpt from Sir Malcolm Livingstone's second journal. Where's the first one? Lamp planter. Seen all this. A lot of rooms. Is that my storage? Yeah, that's my storage. Chronomark watch case? I don't know what all this stuff is, but it's very fascinating. I guess this might end up being my room? Stuff that I found. Oh. What about the lucky boots? Oh, it's a quest item. Oh. All the stuff I found. Mine now. Inaccessible. Don't give me inaccessible. That's unacceptable. Damn you. I can't get that spaceship. Where the AV club hangs out. Oops. I might have seen everything up here. Well, that goes out. Some balcony? Oh, it's kind of like an overview, kind of. Yeah, like a balcony. Oh, that's interesting. Haha. Where the hell? What's all this? Storage box. Chunks chick. I got desktop speakers. Oh, hey. Coachman Equinox. Cool. Hit the mother load here. Many of those, I guess. Very interesting. Two dates for Darla. Forever human. Dr. Andromeda. Huh. Ooh, a plushy star pal? Oh, it squeaked. Oh, it's another one. Cuddlosaur? Haha. It's adorable. Muzzle and Mel, based on a novel by Catherine Okoko. Tau grade rheostat. No idea what that is. Ah, the Borg. I grabbed the Borg cube. I refuse to be assimilated. Refuse, I tell you. Antimicrobial. Wow. Cool. This lock is too difficult. With all the stuff they haven't gotten around to finding out where to display it. Constellation mission board. Approach to activate. Okay, these are different missions. I'm gonna do this yet. Product verified. I already looked at this. I came in the other way now. Alright, so I looked at all these down, these rooms underneath. Oh, not all of them. Oh, that goes down to the well? Where? I probably saw this door before and I just didn't have access. There's always all this water down here? Have I been down here before? I don't remember all the water. Oops. Oops. A little stutter there. I'm just running around in here trying to find out when I see any people or anything. I keep getting these stutters. Oh my god. Chunk's special sauce. Wow, what is with the stutters going on? It's unlocked elsewhere. See, yeah, I'm pretty sure I've never been down here because it's locked from that side. I don't suppose. Oh. Oh yeah, this is where I came from. Felt like I should restart the recording because my audio stopped there for a second. I don't know what's going on. Speak with Kelton. Okay, he's ready for us to talk to him again. Where we came in. Oops, sorry guys. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. So that's that. And this is all this.
This is all exciting, but really a lot of pressure on us, isn't there? We have to get this right.
What's with the crazy headgear?
Are you doing okay? I'm not sure anyone really asked yet. Don't want you to think we're focused on the artifacts and nothing else. You matter too. You've done something really significant bringing that artifact here. I'm Mateo, theological scholar by trade, but now, well, an explorer like you. It's really good to have you with us.
Well, thanks. These artifacts all came out of caves?
Second one was on Kazaa, buried the same as the one you found. But the first one, right under our noses for years, sitting in storage, masquerading as an oversized paperweight. Can you imagine potentially the greatest discovery in human history collecting dust?
He didn't know what it was. What do you make of the vision I saw? I'm not going to ask him that because I never did say what the vision is. What brought you to Constellation?
Well, there was some overlap in interests. I'd spent years searching for religious relics from human history. I had made a really incredible discovery, only to lose it to a greedy corporation.
Yeah, that's the way it goes.
So I tried to steal it back. In the process, I met Walter. Turned out he owned the corporation. After a long talk, we realized we had a lot in common, and I was invited to join Constellation.
All right.
Take care of yourself.
And you as well. All right, so they've moved into one of the other, or she's gone upstairs. And I heard Walter before.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters available to you.
Yeah, I think so. No, I'm not sure. Which one is mine? I don't know what's up with the stutters. Oh, that's the way down. She went to sleep waiting to talk to me.